Hey everybody, I got this shovel and rake set from Dollar Tree. So first I'm going to be using some Waverly chalk paint in the color ink. And I'm just going to cover both of these up with this chalk paint. You could use spray paint if you would like, but I only had this chalk paint on hand, so I ended up just using that. This did only require one coat. And once those were both completely covered, you want to just allow them to completely dry. So now we're gonna have some fun with some cinnamon. You could also find that at Dollar Tree, and Mod Podge. So first what you wanna do is apply some Mod Podge onto the blade of the shovel. And before that Mod Podge dries, you then just want to put some cinnamon right on top. You then just want to start adding more Mod Podge on top of that cinnamon. And what this is going to do, it's going to create a paste. At first, you may notice that the Mod Podge really isn't sticking onto the blade of the shovel and that it's just kind of sticking to your paintbrush. Don't worry, just keep adding more Mod Podge, keep dabbing and mixing it, and it will just come out looking so flawless. I then just did the same thing to the handle of the shovel, and make sure that you don't forget to get in those grooves of the handle as well. So again, just apply some Mod Podge, then put the cinnamon right on top, add some more Mod Podge on top of the cinnamon until it creates a paste. You then just want to allow that to completely dry. You could either let it air dry, or I just used my heat gun, or you could use a blow dryer. And what this is creating is a very rustic looking shovel. And I did the same process to that rake as well. Once that was completely dry, I then am using some jute string to cover up the shaft. So I just applied some hot glue, and really easy, just begin wrapping that jute string all around the shaft of that shovel. And once you get to the very top, you then just want to put another dab of hot glue just to hold that string in place. And I just love how these came out. So now I had these scrap pieces of wood. I'm going to be applying some Apple Barrel acrylic paint in the color Burnt Umber. And I applied these all around the pieces of wood. Then you want to allow those to completely dry. Once dry, I then just did a dry brush method using some white chalk paint. I then made these stencils off of my Cricut. It says love grows here. So I just placed that stencil right on top of the wood. Make sure that it is completely smooth, and then go ahead and just take that transfer tape right off. And then using a makeup sponge, you could also find a package of these at Dollar Tree. I am just applying some more white chalk paint through the openings of the stencils. Very important when working with stencils, you want to make sure that you don't have too much paint on your sponge. So if you do, just make sure that you offload it on your work surface. So once those were all covered with the chalk paint, I just took that vinyl right off, allow them to completely dry, and then I'm just finding a good placement. And I'll be using some adhesive glue. It's a great substitute for E6000. You could find that at Dollar Tree with a mixture of hot glue to apply these to the shaft of the rake. You then just want to allow that to completely dry for about 30 minutes. And now for the shovel, I am going to be using this bucket that I painted galvanized. I also drilled two holes on the back of the bucket. This way I could put a zip tie right through it to hold that bucket right onto the shaft of that shovel. I'm using this floral foam that also came from Dollar Tree. You could decorate this however you would like, but I just got these flowers from Dollar Tree and I just put those right in. I then just grabbed some raffia and I just made a simple bow out of it. I just did the loop, swoop, and pull method. And I just hot glued the raffia bow right at the bottom of the handles. And what a transformation these came out. I just love these so much. I really hope this inspires you to create your own. If it did, please be sure to sprinkle the love. Thank you so much. And I hope y'all have a good rest of your day. Thanks. Bye.